Good morning, everyone, and welcome once again to our short service of reading and prayers for the talk for Sunday, the 25th of January. It's good that we can be together in one sense, even though we can't be together physically. So let's begin with prayer. Lord, direct our thoughts, teach us to pray, lift up our hearts to worship you in spirit and in truth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So I say it's good to welcome you back again this week, whether you're watching live, well, semi-live this week, as I've had a Sunday off, or whether you're watching later on YouTube or Facebook or through any web links. It's good that we can still, in one sense, be together by the Spirit, joined in worship, joined in prayer for one another and in celebration of our Lord Jesus. This week we're thinking about ordinary things that may be able to improve our lives, make our lives different, and how Jesus used them. So our prayer for this week. God of all mercy, your Son proclaimed good news to the poor and release to the captives and freedom to the oppressed. Anoint us by your Holy Spirit and set all your people free to praise you in Christ our Lord. Amen. And so our reading this week come from John's Gospel, from chapter 2 of John's Gospel. We're continuing to read through John's Gospel at the moment. And this is a story that may be familiar to many people, and maybe not so to others, the story of the wedding at Cana. It's John chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. The next day, there was a wedding celebration in the village of Cana in Galilee. Jesus' mother was there, and Jesus and his disciples were also invited to the celebration. The wine supply ran out through the festivities, so Jesus' mother told him, "They have no more wine." "Dear woman, that's not our problem," Jesus replied. "My time has not yet come." But his mother told the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Standing nearby were six stone water jars used for Jewish ceremonial washing. Each could hold 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told the servants, "Fill the jars with water." Now when the jars had been filled, he said, "Now dip some out and take it to the master of ceremonies." So the servants followed his instructions. When the master of ceremonies tasted the water that was now wine, not knowing where it had come from, though of course the servants knew, he called the bridegroom over. "A host always serves the best wine first," he said. "Then when everyone has had a lot to drink, he brings out the less expensive wine. But you have kept the best until now." This miraculous sign at Cana in Galilee was the first time Jesus revealed his glory, and his disciples believed in him. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for the stories of Jesus we read in our gospel accounts. We thank you for all the things he did and said, and the way he showed not just his glory, but your glory. May this story enable us to grow in faith and in him. Amen. So I said this story is, maybe for many people, quite a familiar story. The wedding at Cana. It's an interesting story about Jesus almost being forced into doing something. And yet there are perhaps ways in which it is similar to our times. There's a celebration and the supply of wine, we're told, runs out. I don't know about you, but I often feel during this time of lockdown and the pandemic, often I feel like I've run out, not necessarily of wine, but of energy, of enthusiasm, of the willingness to do things, just run out. Life is so different at the moment, and while there is hope with these new vaccines that are about, our life is just not the same. Many of the things we rely on each day to get by are missing. Contact with friends and family, being around people, eating together, sharing together, just being with other people. It's all missing. Maybe we have run out. Whatever we have run out of, we need to bring that to God. Jesus' mother brings the attention to Jesus. They've run out of wine. It does seem like a rather odd thing to bring to her son, trained as a carpenter builder, not trained as a wine merchant or wine grower as far as we know. And yet there is expectation in those words. They have run out of wine. And to the servants, do whatever he tells you. Jesus then does something strange with two ordinary things. Very strange for a wedding banquet. I mean, maybe most of us would be tempted to find the nearest off-licence, to find, didn't have to Tesco or Sainsbury's to find what wine they've got and quickly restock supplies. And I'm sure there were places in Jesus' time where you could go and get wine. And yet that's not what Jesus does. He doesn't do the expected. He does the unexpected, but with the ordinary. We're told that these ceremonial jars there used for the ceremonial washing, which would take place before meals, they were ordinary. They were special in the sense that they were for ceremonial washing, but they were just ordinary jars. They were part of Jewish life, and certainly at a wedding. I'm sure everyone managed to do the washing before they ate and drank and took part in the celebration. They were just there, unnoticed probably most of the time, for most of the celebration, unused, it seems at the moment, empty, it seems at the moment. And yet Jesus sees them, and he tells the servants to fill them with water. Water, again, is a very ordinary thing. There's nothing particularly special about water, certainly not for us. In the 21st century, in our Western society, water is just ordinary. We turn the tap and there it comes. And maybe the servants had to go to a well to get it, but water was still reasonably ordinary in Jesus' time. It was nothing special. It was there to use for washing, for drinking, for making things with. Water was there. And yet these two things are combined, the ordinary pots, the ordinary water. And somehow between the pouring of the water in, the taking of the water out to serve to the master of the feast, the water changed. It wasn't water anymore. Somehow it was wine, and not only just wine, but the best wine. The best wine this master of the banquet had tasted all evening. The water was transformed. All those gallons of water transformed. Somehow, we're told this is a sign of who Jesus is. He revealed his glory. A miraculous sign. Transforming the ordinary into the special. And not just in small amounts, in its abundance, so the feast could continue. The celebrations could go on uninterrupted. Maybe there are ordinary things in our lives that we could value more. Ordinary things that go on in each of our lives that we take for granted normally. That maybe during this special time, with the help and the power and presence of our Lord Jesus, those ordinary things can become life-giving. I don't know what they might be for me. I'm not sure what they will be for you either. I guess that's for you to work out with Jesus. But Jesus can take the ordinary things that become special in times of being run out, of being empty, of being uncertain of the future and anxious. What are those ordinary things? Let us each seek our Lord to point out those ordinary things in which we can take fresh sustenance, in which we can be revived, renewed, and even in which we can rejoice. Let us ask him for those things that will enable us to continue through this pandemic, through this lockdown, so that we can continue to be his people, not run out, but overflowing, and overflowing with the best. That is Jesus and his Holy Spirit. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are the God of all creation, that everything belongs to you, and that through your Son, transformation can take place from those ordinary things to become fulfilling, renewing, and rejoicing in. Help us to seek you. Show us those ordinary things that will transform our lives, that will renew our failing spirits, that will give us hope in you once more. Father, we ask these things through Jesus, the Saviour, the miracle worker, the transformer. Amen. And so it's time to pray. And this week, first of all, I pray for those who are seeking to serve us in our communities, particularly the NHS and all people involved in that. So let's pray to our God. Loving God, we thank you that during this time of lockdown, during this time of uncertainty, there are people in our communities who are prepared to give of themselves for the good of all. We thank you for our doctors, nurses and others working in hospitals to tend to the sick and dying, to seek to bring people relief from coronavirus, to seek to restore them to health and to care for their families when they die. Lord, we ask that you will give them perseverance, strength, peace and rest. We pray for all who are working in our care homes, looking after those vulnerable people in our society, the elderly and the infirm. We thank you that many of them now, both the care workers and those people living in the homes, have now been vaccinated to give them some protection. But Lord, we do pray that they will continue to work and care compassionately, that they will continue to love and serve those in their care, and that they will know your strength and peace. And we pray for all those people who are working across our communities and across our country and across our world to be able to bring these vaccines to everybody. We thank you for those who are working in GP surgeries, either giving the vaccine or behind the scenes organising everything, those in our pharmacies, those in all the other centres where people are being given hope of a new future, hope of release from the fear of coronavirus. Bless and guide them, we pray. Sustain them with your love and power. Father, we ask these prayers in the name of Jesus, our Lord. Amen. And today we pray for those people we know. They may be on our church prayer list, they may be on our own prayer lists. People we know who are in need today, people who may feel that they have run out, people who are feeling lonely, people who may be feeling anxious or ill. And so let's pray for all them. Father, we pray for those people who we know and who are known only to you. Those people we seek to love and serve, those people who need to know your love. Father, in whatever circumstance they find themselves, may your presence bring them hope. May they know the touch of your love. May they know the healing of your peace. And may you be with them each and every day, we pray. Amen. And we pray for ourselves. Lord, you have called us to be your people, to live for you and to share your glory with this world. Lord, this is so hard at this time when we're so isolated and cut off. Lord, teach us your goodness in our own lives, that when we share our lives with others through phone calls or emails or Zoom or other ways, that we may bring that goodness into the life of others. Help us to be a blessing to those around us. Help us to bless as we have been blessed. And help us to share the goodness that has been given to us. Sustain each one of us. Bless and guide us, that we may truly seek to serve you in this strange world we live in. Amen. And so let's join together in the words that Jesus taught us to pray, the words of the Lord's Prayer. And so we say together in confidence and in hope, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Another prayer for today. Almighty and everlasting God, we thank you that you have brought us safely to the beginning of this new day. Keep us from falling into sin or running into danger. Order us in all our doings, and guide us to do always what is righteous in your sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So we're almost at the end of our short service, and there'll be another one next week at the same time and in the same places on the 31st of January. Do let us know how you what you think of these services, anything you'd like to see as part of them, anything extra you want to see. Do comment and let us know what's going on. That would be really great. Or send an email directly to me. And so may the God, who is the God of the ordinary and the God of the extraordinary, may he bless you. May he lead you. May he refresh your lives and transform all that you are for his glory's sake. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.